got back half hour ago. You know, Sanjay is gonna take over my classes, and you know, Abby's good to run the lab for a few days, so you know, everything's all set. It was good. You know, a lot of people showed up for, you know, short notice. You know, she had a lot of friends. That was nice to see. He's fine, I guess. I mean, I pretty much just got straight off the plane and went to the church, so it's not like we had a whole lot of time to talk, you know? Not that he would tell me what he was thinking, even if we had, so. I know, I miss you too. I'll call you tomorrow, I'll let you know. You've been a hug for me, all right? All right, I love you too. Bye-bye. Hey, Pop. You want me to heat some of this up? I mean, it's almost dinner time. I thought they did a good job, you know, with the service. And it was nice. It was upbeat. I mean, yeah. For a funeral. You know, Mom's friends were there. It was nice.
I can't see as how you have a right to say anything about a funeral. You don't even believe that your mother had a soul. You think all that's left of her is just a rotting corpse.
Pop, come on. Pop, that's not what I believe, okay? You know, she's still with us, yeah. In our thoughts, in our memories. Okay. Apparently we have to have this conversation again. I get it. Just... not tonight, okay? Just... please, just not tonight.
You're right. It is pointless to talk about salvation with an unbelieving, ungrateful son. You broke your mother's heart.
Pop. Pop! Come on. Hey, Pop, you all right?
Yeah, I'm just catching my breath.
All right, well, I mean, we got plenty of time. We don't have to get this all done today, so.
No. No need to let this stuff lay around here. Your mother's got no use for it anymore. And Lord knows there's no cause to decorate heaven.
Yeah, unless she knew how to go all out when she was celebrating. Hey, you remember that time for, what, my 10th birthday? We had that Olympics party, obstacle course in the backyard, and bike races down the street. We even had a medal ceremony when it was all over. Man, my friends talked about that party for years.
Yeah, I remember.
You sure you're all right, Pop? You know when we get your water?
I said I'm fine. The faster we sort through this, the faster you can go home and get on with your life.
You know what? That is not fair. I got just as much right to be here as you do. I mean, I just lost my mother, for Christ's sake. I loved her too, Pop. The only reason I'm here is to help you and say goodbye. And the least you could do... the least you could do is acknowledge that.
Hello?
Josie Dudley. She's in the choir with your mother.
I know where she is, Pop.
Back here, Josie!
Well, there you all are. I wondered what the Wade men would be getting into today. I just wanted to bring over this chicken casserole for lunch.
Morning, Josie. I appreciate this.
Thank you, Mrs. Dudley.
Well, would you look at all this? Whoever knew Margaret had such a passion for decorations?
Ethan, take the casserole off Miss Dudley's hands. I know it's got to be getting heavy.
Oh, well, Ethan, sweetie, how are you holding up? Seems like ages since you were home last. Your mother was always talking about your family and, oh, your research. You study ants, right? But not how to get rid of them?
Me and my team, we study a very specific species of ant and the way they communicate.
Is that so? How fascinating.
All species of ant, as it turns out, their communication is very modular and chemical. They have their own kind of language. Only for them, chemical traces for them are like words for us. We study a very specific ant. It's the Argentine ant. You may have heard of it. It's considered an invasive species, but
Your mother sure was proud of you.
Well, I talked to her about it. I guess I didn't know she had any real interest in my work. So,
of course she did. She was your mother.
Yes, she was.
We prayed for you too. In Bible class nearly every week. I hope you're going to let Jesus back into your heart soon.
Well, that's nice. Thank you. I appreciate you thinking of me.
Of course, of course. We're going to miss your mother so very much. She made the best Christmas cookies.
Excuse me. Thanks for coming by, Josie.
Don't forget to eat something now.
Well, I guess she hasn't changed much. Still got everybody else's business in her prayers but her own.
It was good of her to bring us something to eat.
Obviously, Pop. I'm not saying she did anything wrong. I just...
Why don't you take the casserole up and put it in the refrigerator with the others?
Today. I don't know, maybe tomorrow we can take a load down to Goodwill.
Just like that. Just move on, huh? Exactly how are you going to live with this, Ethan?
Pop, you said it yourself. She doesn't have any need for all this stuff anymore.
Don't you pretend to misunderstand me, boy. I'm talking about you. thinking your mother no longer exists, doubting that there's another world where she's fine and we'll get a chance to see her again. I just don't understand how you're going to live with that kind of emptiness.
I'm not saying she doesn't exist anymore. I'm not being trite when I tell you she's still here. You know, she's a part of us. Psychologically, biologically, she's still here.
She's gone, Ethan. She's not here.
I came from her body, okay? She's a part of me. You know what? Benjamin, he came from my body, so she's a part of him too. That's a fact. Scientific and demonstrable.
Scientific fact. What comfort is that? Science just wants to take away everything that gives people meaning in their lives. Boil the whole world down to nothing but just a bunch of numbers.
Okay. Well, now who's deliberately misunderstanding? You know what? Science doesn't take meaning. It gives it. Science is us dealing with the world on its own terms. I find that a whole lot more comforting than some pie-in-the-sky nonsense that doesn't have anything to do with the measurable world.
The meaning of life is to fear God and to keep His commandments.
Okay, well, there's no logical response to that, so...
Well, maybe it's time that you admit that you're wrong.
Do you even remember helping me do those science projects when I was a kid? I mean, you bought me my first ant farm, mostly to keep me from digging up the yard. And then when Mom found out I wanted to learn about ants, she took me down to the library and we checked out every book we could find. That Christmas, when I was 7, and you and Mom got me that big telescope. Becca and I just gave that telescope to Ben for his 5th birthday. He knows more constellations than I do.
He's a smart kid.
My point is, you and Mom helped me discover science. Now, how's it all of a sudden the enemy?
All right, son. You want to play Let's Remember? Let's see if you can remember this. Your mother and I scraped and saved to send you to that college. Then when it was all over, you came back just to tell us that you had abandoned God, to rub it in our faces. You broke your mother's heart.
That is not what happened! I didn't rub it in your face. I was just being honest with you. And you know what? Mom understood why I was leaving the church.
No. She just didn't want you to know how much it hurt her. She never understood.
She did.
She stopped talking to me about that after I sent you that letter. But I know how it was. Whenever she spoke with you on the phone, for a couple of days later, she'd be quiet, but I could see the worry.
Well, she didn't need to, right? I love my work.
It cost you your faith, Ethan. You started thinking that job could replace every truth your mother and I taught you. The ant farm, the science projects, the telescope, those were all to help you examine God's creations. The heavens declare the glory of God. Remember that?
Yeah, I remember. I just don't see the world that way anymore.
You're seeing it wrong then. See, son, look. When you say that you don't see God's hand in this creation, what you're saying is that there's no hope, that suffering has no purpose. What you're saying is, your mother was wrong about her entire life.
on, Pop. I'm not saying any of that stuff. I'm not saying it's hopeless or pointless or any of that. Mom led a good, full life. She loved me. She loved you.
You can't say anything to me to make me think you were right to throw your faith in the garbage.
You know what? We've been having the same fight for 15 years, and you have never once heard me out. I mean, what's the matter? You scared? Huh? You think if you listen for too long, I'll make too much sense?
You broke your mother's heart, and now she's not here for you to apologize to. I hope you're happy.
I didn't expect Mom to die. I didn't want her to die. She just did. And I got just as much right to comfort as you do. You know what's funny? I haven't even gotten to the grieving part yet, because I'm so busy fighting you off or making peace with you, or whatever the hell it is we keep doing. I'm her son. I'm your son. How come you can't just give me a chance to tell you how I see it? So, look, you're right. I don't think Mom's in heaven, okay? But look, just give me a chance here, okay? It's not like I have some big speech planned out in my head. Okay, so the way I like to think of it is all of our bodies have this kind of a molecular trajectory, okay? All our cells are constantly either growing or dividing and, yeah, even dying, right? But they're just making way for new life. Oh, perfect example. So the top layer of your skin is constantly flaking off and dying, okay? But it's just making way for new cells to push up from the bottom. And we're literally just being rebuilt from the inside out.
Skin is not the issue.
No, okay. Look. There's this idea in science called the law of the conservation of energy, right? It says that the universe, it's a closed system, okay? And so, because it's closed, energy can't be created and it can't be destroyed. It can only change forms. To me, that's what death is. It's just a change in form.
I don't get your point.
My point is, Mom is not gone. She's all around us. And not some mystical way. But I mean in ways that can be observed and calculated. Her body is in flux the same way it was her entire life. It's going to keep changing. And she's going to go on and she's going to become a part of the world in a different way than she was before. Her molecules will be reorganized and her energy will be dispersed into the world, but it'll never actually be gone. It's always going to be around us. There's literally no other place for it to go.
That's not exactly biblical, son.
No, it's not. But it makes sense, doesn't it? And to me, that is, it's a whole lot more comforting than any of the stuff that I was getting in that funeral today. Oh, smile, she's with Jesus. You know, Jim Rowe, he actually walked up to me and said, "Oh, you just being selfish. You know, God needed her more than you did."
Yeah, he told me that too.
There's this idea across all kinds of fields of science that says that every creature that's ever been, Earth, the moon, the galaxy, every person that's ever been, they're all made out of the same stuff. They're all built from materials that were forged in stars. You know, and eventually, that's where we're all going to go back to. It's not heaven. I admit it. Okay, but the idea of, you know, sharing this destiny with everything that's ever been, I mean, that comforts me. It comforts me the way church used to.
I just don't know what you want from me, Ethan. I can't agree with you.
Look, Pop, you don't have to agree with me. All I'm trying to tell you is I can't agree with you either.
All right.
Look, you're not alone, Pop. I don't want to be alone either.
All right. All right. You know, I think I've had about as much of this conversation as I can take. Maybe we can go sit out on the back for a while.
That sounds good, Pop.
You can tell me about that grandson of mine, how he's doing. Maybe we can see if we can name some of those constellations that he knows. Ethan.
Huh?
I do remember the ant farm. You quit digging up the backyard, sure enough. You had those ants running up and down your bedroom wall. Gave your mom quite a shock, if I recall.
Think we're gonna be all right, Pop.